Okay, now we finished talking about ARDS, and we mentioned that a big problem in ARDS is atelectasis and derecruitment, which leads to worsening hypoxia. And that's why we do the recruitment maneuvers plus preventing decrease the recruitment, all of this to improve oxygenation. Okay, as you know by now that derecruitments happens mainly during expiration, right? That's when the alveolar pressure goes down and the airflow out, so the risk of atelectasis and the recruitments during expiration. That's the goal of PEEP during expiration, right? To prevent this. Okay, one theory was, so why don't we decrease expiratory time and increase inspiratory time? That way, the risk of derecruitment will be less because the expiratory time is less. And that's where the idea of inverse ratio ventilation. It's not a mode of ventilation, it's a strategy where you flip the IE ratio. We always said that inspiration is shorter than expiration. But in this strategy, you flip. So inspiratory time, you make it bigger than expiratory time. That way you make it less likely and less time for derecruitment and allow the alveoli to stay open and help improve oxygenation. I have to say that this strategy, we only use it as kind of last resort. When the patient has 100% FiO2, let's say, and a high amount of PEEP and all the strategy to treat the underlying cause and still hypoxic. So we can use it for short period of times to improve oxygenation. And when you get to this point of inverse ratio ventilation, you have to have an intensivist involved. All this course mainly intended toward internal medicine residents or residents in general and internists. But once you get to this point, I highly recommend, if you start thinking about this, you should have had already an intensivist or pulmonary critical care physician involved. The famous one of inverse ratio ventilation is what we call bi-level ventilation, which I'm gonna talk briefly about during next video.